And one person asked me, why is it that you have grown a beard? And it looks white. And does not suit your face. I said that I came with a white beard because of a very specific purpose. Just to show that this beard was black, jet black, 400 sessions ago. You won't believe the way we started. It was not in September 2008 when our club was chartered. It was a year before that, in beginning of 2007, and maybe it was the end of 2006, when a few of the Oman Toastmasters egged me to provide a platform so that Oman Toastmasters could meet within Morison Muscat Toastmasters. And at that time, Oman Toastmasters had to close down when, I'm sure many of you know that for a number of years, Toastmasters in Oman was asked not to function. And I was one of those clubs which were asked to shut down, and I felt so dejected because the session in which I had given my CC10, Project 10 speech, at the end of that speech, and I came out thinking that everybody will recognize me and congratulate me, the shocking news came that Toastmasters in Oman had been asked to close down. That was in the year 2004. And it took about 3 years after for the same members to come back to me, maybe with a reason. I was the treasurer of Oman Toastmasters when it closed down. And in my bank account, I had 1,000 riyals of the club. They were all worried about the 1,000 riyals more than anything else. I said, 1,000 riyals is safe. This has got to be surrendered to Toastmasters. Now that you have come up the ninth year, let's use this for forming a club. And that club can be within Morison Muscat Chartered Accountants. That was the beginning of Morison Muscat Toastmasters, with 1,000 riyals of somebody else's club and the members of that club coming together to form MMTC. That's the story behind the scenes. I'm sure none of you have heard about the story, but that's the fact. With the help of somebody else, we are existing today. That's what I want all of you to understand. We have not come just like that. It is the sweat and tears and blood and effort of others that has been responsible for the creation of this club. And we owe them all a sense of gratitude. At the 300th session of Morison Muscat Toastmasters, I was once again present and I was asked to give an impromptu speech or a presentation, and the electrical system or the IT system failed. And I had no other chance, no other option but to talk about impromptu, and I did not know whom to talk about, and I spoke about all the presidents of MMTC until that time. And I roasted them, because each one came with their own strengths and weakness, and I only picked up the weakness. And they were very good at their weakness, and that's what enabled other members to compensate. This was the kind of complementary effort or complementary vibe that was felt among the members. Today I now come not to praise the presidents or their strengths, or to praise those of the members here, but to tell you all that there is a story behind MMTC's reason for it reaching this current state of excellence. And that formula is very, very simple. The formula is power to the power of five. Now let me explain to you very briefly what this power to the power of five is. The first power is the power of humility. All the members that have come into Morison Muscat have embraced this quality. Whenever somebody came here, he was not introduced as managing partner of so-and-so, or managing director of so-and-so, or general manager of so-and-so. He was just introduced as a member of the club, an ordinary member of the club, who will have to deliver speeches and be evaluated also. It was at that starting point, the quality of humility started. And everybody felt and embraced this with wholeheartedness. The second power was the power of simplicity. We kept everything simple. We didn't want to make it grand for the sake of making it grand. And the simplicity itself created a lot of grandeur in the hearts of the members who came to attend meetings. And today, I was really touched by the speech of Prakash Bhore. It might not have been a great speech, but I foresee in him, a speaker of great value, as well as a speaker who can motivate others, a speaker who will one day achieve his dreams within MMTC. We have seen that happen. And right in front of you, you have also seen another speaker who has reached that stage following his speech, this Toastmaster Raghu Salim. When he first joined us, he was like Prakash Bhore. Today, how do you see him? He has been inspiring us flawlessly with his speech. And that's where I see all of us in that direction going towards. The confidence with which Prakash spoke really touched my heart, because he wouldn't open his mouth for 1 year here in MMTC. Today he's got a smile on his face, and that's what really touched me. This is what makes members stick here. And the third power is of understanding. All of us understand our strengths and weaknesses. And because we understand that, nobody feels bad about it. Nobody feels very proud about his strengths. At the same time, nobody feels bad to make mistakes. That atmosphere has been created here in Morison, Muscat, Toastmasters, my dear friends. And because of these three underlying qualities, there was a fourth power that emerged, the power of attraction. Because we had these qualities ingrained as our foundation, people started being attracted to our club. Just like the champion speaker, Mohammed Shukri, who came here and spoke, he was attracted to our club. It was not because each individual member was great, but because we had laid the foundation for attraction. And so I am very confident that whether I am here or not here, the members here will continue to attract other members, because it has the foundation of personal development. The opening sergeant at arms had stumbled in reading out the mission statement. That doesn't matter. The very fact that we have come here for self-development is what prompts us to make mistakes. And I'm sure that from 10 sessions from now, it will be a flawless rendition of the mission statement, because that mission statement would have got ingrained within him, and there would be a desire for him to do that likewise in every session that follows. The fifth power is that of excellence. If Morison Muscat has excelled, it's only because of the previous four powers. And that is why I say the power to the power of five has been responsible for the excellence of Morison Muscat Toastmasters. And this power of excellence is not the power of winning, it's the power of performing. And because we are here performing, week after week, we see improvements in our members. And I see every one of you becoming champion communicators. You need not be champions, but you will definitely be champion communicators. You need not be political leaders, but definitely you will be leaders in your own area of influence. That's what this laboratory, as I've always said, will enable you to do. The cumulative effect of all the members, of all the office bearers, the founders, the mentors. We had excellent people, and I'm sure they will come and also share their own respective experiences of what they had with Morison. And it has got nothing to do with me, or nothing to do with my gray hair, or nothing to do with my youth. It is all because of the members present here that they have, it has been possible for us as a family to excel. Let's continue the good work. Mr.